In this video, I'll show you how to use a capture card to record gameplay from any Xbox console at the best possible quality. Let's get started. Firstly, we'll get the capture card set up correctly with all of the connections required. After that, I'll show you how to record footage using OBS or Streamlabs in Windows. For this example, we're using the AVMedia Ultra S that will allow up to 4K 60 recording and pass-through. But this resolution and frame rate will differ on each capture card, so you might want to check now what to expect. In the box of the capture card, you should have the capture card itself, of course, one HDMI cable, and one USB cable. If you look at your capture card, you'll see there should be at least three ports, two for HDMI, one in and one out, and the USB. Some capture cards may have extra ports like analog audio inputs or alternate display outputs. You usually won't need to use these, but in some cases additional connections and settings might be required. Move all of these cables and the capture card to one side for now and switch your attention to your Xbox. We need to disconnect the HDMI cable from the back of it first. This is the cable that you will have already, that is connected to your monitor or TV. Leave it connected to the monitor, but disconnect it from the back of the Xbox and put it to one side for now. In its place, connect the new HDMI cable that came with your capture card into the back of the Xbox. Then connect the other end of the new cable into the HDMI in port on the capture card. Next, connect the other end of the old HDMI cable into the HDMI out port on the capture card. So now there should be HDMI from the Xbox to the card in port, then HDMI from the card out port to your monitor or TV. The final cable to connect is the USB cable. Insert one end into the capture card and the other into your PC or laptop. It's important to check the USB port you're connecting it to, as it's best to use the one that will allow for the highest data transfer speeds. For example, check if your PC has a red USB 3.2 port. You can always try a few different ports if you're unsure, and this might only be a problem if you want to capture the highest resolutions and frame rates. The diagram on screen shows how each cable is connected and where it needs to be so you can check everything matches up. Some capture cards may require external power, so you might need to connect this in addition to the connectors we've already used. We'll now get the capture card set up on your PC or laptop. After connecting the USB, some software might already be requesting to install, which you can do by following each step. This will differ depending on your capture card. If nothing showed up, you might need to get this software or drivers from the capture card manufacturer's website. For example, head to the official Elgato or AVMedia page for your capture card and download and install the software it shows here. This might not be necessary, but I recommend checking anyway, as this software may have drivers and will also provide an alternative way to record footage outside of OBS or Streamlabs. Type in your exact model of capture card and then follow the link to the manufacturer's webpage for this card, and all the information on what you need should be on here. I'll include a link to both Elgato and AVMedia's official sites, which you can use to then search for your capture card. For example, you can use Elgato's downloads page to select your capture card, and it will then show you the software required. For the newer Elgato cards, this will be 4K capture utility. For older cards, you'll need to use the legacy section and probably get Game Capture HD instead. If you haven't already, you can download and install OBS or Streamlabs now. The method will be very similar for both. Again, I'll include links in the description for this. You can also power on your Xbox console now. Open OBS or Streamlabs once it's installed. If you want a full installation guide, then click the card or follow the link in the description for my video on that. We'll now add the capture card's footage to OBS or Streamlabs. If you have the recording software open for your capture card already, such as 4K Capture Utility for Elgato, make sure it is closed before you open OBS, as you can't use both at the same time. Also, make sure your Xbox console has now started up. Firstly, find the Sources section and click on the Add Source button. In OBS, it's this plus icon. From the menu, choose Video Capture Device. Next, we need to give this a name. You can leave this as it is, but it might be helpful to name it the same as your capture card. Click on OK, and now check the device drop-down menu and select your capture card. If you don't see it here, try each of the options to see if it's one of them. If it still isn't working, check for any extra software or setup required for your capture card, or try the capture card's own recording software to see if that shows the video. With your capture card chosen, you should see a preview of your Xbox. Again, double check it is turned on, and you could even check the picture is working on your monitor, which it should now. You can customize the other settings on this page, however, leaving them as default should work. Click on OK. Next, look to the preview and resize the capture card's video in the window. It should snap to the full size. And now have a look in the audio mixer. Adding the capture card should have automatically added the audio for it, so you can find it and customize its sound level, and also test that the audio is working. You could try adding an audio source for the capture card manually, just like we did for the video section. If you want to use the microphone on your PC for live voiceover, you'll need to add this audio source. Click on the plus icon in the Sources section, then choose Audio Input Capture, give it a name, then select your microphone. We'll now customize more settings in OBS to ensure the quality is what you want. Open the settings. In OBS, this is the settings button in the bottom right. In Streamlabs, it might be in the bottom left. Within the settings, head to the Output tab. On here, you can customize both the streaming and recording sections to your preference. These will affect the quality of streaming and recording. It's likely that you'll need to continue to customize these settings after you test recordings, for example with the bitrate if you're streaming from OBS, or the recording quality for videos. Other settings you'll want to check on here are the recording file output path, which is where your recordings will be saved. Also, check the recording format is best for you. MP4 should work with everything you need, but you can change this depending on what you want to do with the recording file and the editing software you use. Next, head to the Audio tab and check this is set correctly. If you have any issues with audio after recording, you could try a different sample rate. Most of this should be set correctly already. Finally, in the Video Settings tab, you can set the recording resolution and frame rate. You could match this to the highest resolution and frame rate that your capture card is capable of. Make sure you click on OK or apply to save these changes. You might want to come back to this section after we've changed settings on your Xbox, as this could give you more quality settings if you think some are missing. We'll now move on to the setup on the Xbox console. If you use the same monitor for your PC and Xbox, switch the input to the Xbox now. Open the settings on your console. You can do this by pressing the Xbox button on the controller, then scroll through to the profile page and choose the settings option. Within the settings, make sure you're in the general section on the left, and then select TV and display options. First, we can check that the resolution and refresh rate is set correctly. You might want to match this to the maximum pass-through of your capture card. This is either the same or higher than the recording quality that your capture card is capable of, and it will differ for each. You can try the maximum the Xbox will allow in these settings, but if this causes any problems with the recording, you can reduce them here. You can check the 4K TV details to see more information about what the monitor supports, and if you select video modes in the advanced column, here you can change other quality settings, for example enable 4K or HDR if this is supported. Next, head back to the homepage of the settings, and this time choose volume and audio output from the general section. In here, you could customize these settings or try different ones if the audio isn't working in recordings. Before leaving the settings, choose additional options within the advanced column here, and if your party chat was not being captured in the recordings, you could test each of the party chat options here to see if one of these works. If your capture card uses a separate audio input, like a 3.5mm cable from your Xbox controller, you might need to adjust an extra setting in OBS. I've linked more info on this in the description. The Xbox should now be ready, and if you see the preview and have audio coming through, you're ready to record or stream in OBS. All you need to do is click on the record button and then stop it once you're done. The file will be saved to the location we set earlier in the video. I'd now recommend watching back the recording and then making any adjustments required, such as the quality settings. That's how to use a capture card to record gameplay from your Xbox console. Click the card on screen now to watch a video of mine showing you how to stream to Twitch from OBS on your PC or laptop. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comments below, and if you did find today's video helpful, remember to leave a like and feel free to subscribe for more tips in the future. Be sure to stick around to see some of my other videos that you might be interested in. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in another video.